every single journal like that, the present reason was to match against a people problem. I also believe that your life has been recovered. And every experience you have counts towards the next moment, unless you choose not to use it. So today, I'm not a partner. I'm the power sector. I'm the CEO of the electricity distribution company. It's in four states. Edo, Delta, Edo and East. I learned how, I'm very happy about the movement. Different way for, and I know the power sector is a serious issue for everyone. And different cultures, different ways of handling issues. We shall not have a problem. Every time we came to Borno State, I said, oh my God, what's the problem? Now it's half of us. Sometimes I do my own dance with them. But I think that in every issue, we don't know what we do, but some of it, and we don't know what it is. We don't have a lot of time. In those four locations, we have 1,500 teams in transformation. I'm also a part of, in our group, that's a good group, and the vice chairman transformation. He gave me a challenge, who happens to be my husband. He looked up and said, I think you should be vice chairman transformation. I felt good. I said, well, hey, how do you do it? And he went up. And this is in my comfort zone. No problem. I did not know if I was inviting problem for myself. Because at the first time, when something is given to you, you must find a way of doing it. Who used to do a marketing from the world and an infrastructure company? I just found out that just it would have been easier for me to just keep moving my power zone. But by adding that means whether I like it or not, I will do things for the other businesses we have, and we have over 6 businesses.
Always have passion, persistence, and patience. And these are 3 things that I always kind of ask myself when I'm moving forward. I've sat in a waiting room for 7 hours once to meet with someone, and I think that's pretty patient.
But that professionalism that I started with, which I have not to, that's the mentality that was in my life, which I didn't notice. I was not told that I started with a business that didn't have limitations. That's hard work and focus and not a work at all. A little bit of similar happened to me like that. I think my last meeting, I literally finished one course of me. I didn't know I was going to have a baby that day. I woke up, it was in working class. And I went out there. I got woke up and saw what I was going to do. First time I had that type of experience, and I thought, you are too good for me. Until I touched it on my body, I thought my stomach was something. I then my husband said, I go up to the second room, right now, I can't answer him. For another 3 hours, I was going to fall. And I did not buy a single thing. When I got to the hospital, even less than an hour, I had to be. And the first person I was calling was my friend to say, I'm in the hospital, I just had a baby. He said, you can't see me, so I didn't know that. Well, he was expecting that you could be so traumatized that somebody else would be able to tell him, I went back to home. Not because it was compulsory for me, but because life was consuming. But I didn't see it as an angel. So, do whatever you want to do, like I was said before. Tenacity matters. And balancing things matters. For all of us, I know what to look at it. It's not just a problem. There are 4 aspects I always say that only two matters. The world,
consists of being professional in terms of our attitudes and basically doing our homework and research and having a very strong vision for what might be. And at the end of the day, the patience, the persistence and the passion really to push us beyond what we believe our comfort zone and to be able to press through into one of the things that we are striving for. There's another question, let me address it to you, and it says there's so many successful, powerful males out there, and on the other hand, the woman's brain is overshadowed by the body. How does one live?
And I think all women have a responsibility, like all women in the school, to dress responsibly. You know, and we shouldn't, you know, the women want to dress in well, but we shouldn't also dress in a way that we put ourselves at risk, whether in public, you know, or in small groups. You know, you should dress like, you should dress as a role that you're expected to do. And if it's a professional capacity, you know, what's about professional capacity? That's a perfect thing.
We've come to the end of Business Incorporated. Please don't forget to send us your comments and questions to businessincorporated@channelstv.com. Thank you for watching. I'm Bolaji Akinwale. See you next time.